Welcome to Fallout 76, the game you just can't fix, live-in camp tours. In this series, we will take a look at some of my camps, some friends' camps, and who knows, maybe your camp. Know a cool place to build? Make sure to let me know in the comments. Today we are here in the ash heap. You see, this metal shack that you see behind me is here from before, as you know if you play the game. And there's a cat here called Murgle. Now, one thing I want to say about Murgle. Murgle is a really, really cute cat and I wanted to give her a new home, right? That was the idea. Yes, I did. But Murgle keeps dying. Yeah, she does. And she'll probably die during this recording because she just dies by herself for no obvious reason. I don't know if... you know, she gets poisoned by the food. If you saw her, she was... Oh god, is she dying? No, she's still alive. She's still alive. Oh, thank god, yeah. By the food that she eats in her little bowl over there, or what it is, I'll show you. But if you do know, let me know, okay? I've got to move from this place, because I just can't stand it. No, I can't. It's just heartbreaking. Yes, it is. So, there we go. But the spot is fantastic. It is a location, location, location. I have never sold as much as I've done being in this spot. It is here on the map, just north of Welsh Station. There we go. You go up the hill from Welsh Station and you come to this little shack with Murgle. So let's just start over here, shall we? This concrete square here with this barbecue area is here from before, but there's no fire. And, you know, everything looks very crappy when you come here, you know, very crappy. I place down the Meat Week flag, of course, fittingly. Made a little stage area here. Now I can turn on the radio because I turn them off in game. So you have this beautiful little light there. And the thought is, of course, that this is the artist, the performer's place, yes. That will sing and sing and play the guitar for the guests that sit around the barbecue. Now I make sure that the chairs are facing the barbecue. Of course I did, like this. It's very important, these little details. Can't have people facing all over the place, right? No. That doesn't work, that doesn't work. Fantastic little place. This coffee sign is here from before, and I was able to put the lights underneath, believe it or not. Awesome. In this corner here, I squished a fireplace and the cuckoo clock and a little comfy chair. And then, you know, used that chair that was here from before as a table. Also, these chairs are here from before. That little coffee cup on there is there. So, you know, it has these little things. I put that lamp on that suitcase so it didn't look as much as garbage, more like a little table. And this is Murgle's little bowl. There she is, still alive, believe it or not. She's so cute. I mean, look at that. Oh. I tried to tame her with the Wasteland Whisper, the animal friend, I mean. And it doesn't work. It doesn't work. I tried both of them. Doesn't work. You can't tame her and have her as your own, I think. I might have done something wrong. If you know something differently, let me know in the comments. This area is also here. It's full of, you know, it has some coffee pots and stuff, and I just remove them usually because I think it looks so cluttery, but you can have it there. And the footlocker and safe that resets every day, so you get some loot there. And you can also keep stuff there, but you know, it disappears, so don't keep it there for longer than... But I don't know. I hang the meat cleaver up there. Fittingly, I thought, since it's a coffee shop, right? Is it too... No, sorry, not meat cleaver. I'm sorry, the tenderizer. Yes, I got that in the Meat Week... events, yes, and my diploma from being on the map in Nuclear Winter, the new map, the Morgantown map, it was, yes indeed. Oh god, she's still alive. here I put down a big rustic table, and one more chair so that it would look a little newer, because those three metal chairs, they were here from before. But to make it look a little nicer, I put down an extra chair, even though it is a little cramped, but you can actually use them. Some of these chairs are facing the wrong way. I mean, Bethesda, what are you doing? This is facing the right way, right? So that's fine. Fine, dandy there. And that picture that you saw that is also here from before, I think it's this chair that faces the wrong way. Yeah, look at this. Look at this. Ah, God dang it. No, I am kidding. Okay, putting on the radio so that the light comes on, because it's so cozy. Yes, indeed. The picture there of Murgle that is there from before, but the little light and the radio and the plant I put there. These cups too, here from before. It's really cool. Really cool. I put up the poster and the lights and that coffee sign up there. That was also here from before. The statue I put down. Now here, if you drink from that, you get teleported somewhere, because I usually have a Nuka Shine in it, yes I do. In this little shack, I was able to have a magazine rack, of course. I was able to squish the shop, which I was really happy with. Now in the beginning, I was just gonna have one shop, but then I have so many plants I have to sell, so I made this little plateau there to the right, so you could have more than one shop here for sure, you know. That the couch Murgle actually sleeps on. That's so cute when she goes to sleep there. And I put some posters up here to cover up a plaque that looked kind of dirty and old, right? My flamingos. Apparently just have one. I think I forgot to put the other one down. I almost always have these pink flamingos in my builds. Put some plants here to make it look like, you know, it's a cafe, so they need their vegetables and stuff to make food over it. And behind here I have my workstations. So the Tinkerbell with some posters and stuff, the workbench, put a candle on that fridge because that fridge is here from before. And some boxes to just, you know, populate it, sort of. I was also able to squish the armor bench in the boat that's here. That was kind of cool. I used that rug. If you don't know, if you use that rug, and that specific rug, you can place things underneath other things and that sort of thing. There she's still alive. Woohoo! Amazing. This cooking stove, I wanted to have the other way, so I placed it the other way, but if you do that, it doesn't work, you can't use it, so that's why I placed it this way. It doesn't look that good, but hey, it's at least functional, right? And this stove is here from before. I put a light on it, and here, you know, I put a chair so I can sit here if I'm, you know, AFK. And then it looks like someone's tempting the cafe. Indeed, I love these little things. Yes. Okay. Here we go. I have some Farshnok stuff up there. Oh god. Did I get stuck? I got stuck. I didn't get stuck. This last time I did it, let's do it again. I think I need to have the chair a little further back, don't you think? Let's see if we can get out of it now. Yes. It's a little part of the meat cleaver, I see. No, sorry, the tenderizer sticking through the wall. Never mind. Eat well, live well, and employees must wash hands before returning to work. These are important things. And the Nuka-Cola clock. I always have that for sale, by the way. No, maybe not always. A lot of times. I love these clocks. These clocks, wall clocks, I put on my builds. I love them. The big one and the little one, indeed. Yes, I do. Over here I have some a water pump, because there is no nearby water source. So, you know, to get boiled water, I need dirty water, so that I get from these water pumps. that is a little drawback by this location, you know, not only that the cat dies, but also that there's no, like, water close by if you use a lot of, like me, I like to use Berrymantad, and so, you know, I make a lot of Berrymantad, so then that's a little drawback. Here I put the chemistry station up on one of these crates that was here from before. Sorry, Norwegian in the house. It works, yes indeed. You teleport up there when you want to craft, and as you see, it doesn't look strange. It looks like you're standing on that crate. Some crates for decoration, and here is the restrooms for the customers. It is a unisex restroom, absolutely. Open the door. Lola. I thought that was kind of cute. Yes, I did. These wood scraps are here from before, so you can get wood every day. Yes, indeed. Very, very nice. Don't have to go to the forest. No, you don't. I also made a little shower area. I see my... Oh my god, she's thirsty. I'm pretty thirsty. I need to drink something. I actually managed to put the one of the brewing stations on this table. And it looked really cool. But then I discovered that the cat sits there. You know, that's one of the places she goes to sit. So I removed it again. But you can actually have it. It looked kind of cool with the flames and stuff. So there. But maybe you can squish it in behind the counter in the kitchen too, you know. That could be cool. That could be cool. I haven't tried that. That's something you can try. Yeah, I have a shower area, but first I want to show you my bedroom. And the bedroom is up here. Yes, indeed. Just put the bed there with the suitcase and, you know, the lanterns. And this, I love this statue. And, you know, since this is a coffee shop with her, you know, being the water bearer or what she is, you know, fit, didn't it? Yeah, that fit. So let me show you the bathroom or the shower area. Also smack down some plants here to make it so not so gloomy, sort of. Also the flag on the wall there. Here it is. Here's my little shower area. So you can turn it on here. Activate. Look at that. A little scary with the electrical and water, isn't it? But hey, it works. And cleanliness is godliness, as we all know. Yes. This is a trick. I don't want to, you know, I hate big flat buildings. So if I can use one square, I'm happy with that. So I use this defense thing instead to end it. And then I squish these generators in one of these tracks. This is my most common way of hiding this generator. Now, I was a little, you know, I had a, what you call it, not much time when I made this. So I should have tried and moved this a little more to the left, which you can do, because then it won't stick out of the roof. No, that it does here. But you put the roof down last. So first you put down the floors and the walls and this thing here, and then you can put this generator into this, and then the last thing you do is smack the roof on, right? I think I placed down the generator in this thing first and then moved this thing, so that this thing moves the generator. Yes, it does. You see that? Yeah, and I put the generator on a rug to make it sit on this defensive structure here. Yes, indeed. I remember now. And I have a flag there from Farsnacht. Yes, indeed. Farsnacht flag. I put a turret up because sometimes there are mole men that spawn here. So protect Murgle, you know, I put that down, indeed. Now, over here, in this truck, I have what do you call me? Brewing station, yes. The brewing station and the fermenter that I put in this truck. And I was so happy with the fact that I could actually put them in here. Because you know the fermenter, you just transfer stuff to, so you don't have to have access to it. And but this you have to. But I could put it here, and that, you know, that works fine. It works. It's functional. In this truck, love that. And this is also to kill off some mole men that spawns here. And I made sure to make my plot so big that I could have a sign here when you come up the hill from my Welsh station. So I put an arrow there for people to see where to go. And if you run down this hill, you'll see Welsh station right there. Right there it is. And also, you know, if you're a medium level, it's a superb place to be, because you can just go down here and there's loads of mole men here. So, you know, it's a good place to level when you are medium level, for sure, for sure. And this is how it looks when you come from the station. Yes. And also hanged some Farsnak stuff up there. She's still alive. I am amazed. Yeah. So I don't know why Murgle dies. I have no idea. If you know why she just suddenly insta-dies, let me know in the comments. And explain this to me, because to me it is a mystery. Like sometimes, like now, she stays alive for a long time, and like when I built it, she was alive for a long time. And then times she just dies and dies and dies for, I have no idea why. I don't know why. You know, I could be here and build for the longest time. There's no mole man coming, no nothing. She just suddenly, boop, she's dead. There's no people around either. It's very, 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 very strange. If you're wondering, this thing to hang from the ceiling there and this thing in the corner is from Farsnacht. Also this, yeah, I forgot to show you this thing. Here on the wall, you say, it says jobs now or else, right? I didn't want that in the coffee shop, no. Bring down the mood, so I put those to hide that writing on the wall. Indeed I did. And up here, this bulb isn't working, so I put a new one, so we would have some light in that light pole. And that's it for this camp. Yes, indeed, it is it for my ash heap cat build. I'm sorry if some of my English wasn't correct in this episode. I am Norwegian. Don't forget to leave a comment, subscribe, then the bell, and click the likey button.